Yo, we're back. We're finishing it. We're actually doing it. We're doing it. How many months has it been? We'll find out when I post it.
I did all of Dead Space since we quit.
Yeah.
It's just more like games came out that I really wanted to play, and also this game sucks. Didn't want to play it. But we're doing it. So asterisk is that I am out of practice. It's been like 2-3 months now. I am playing okay, but I have to play all the hardest songs right now, so don't expect too much. But yeah.
6 stars, which if you remember, it's been a very long time, but the only way to get 6 stars in this game is for everyone to FC.
Yeah, double FC.
Not 100% FC. Which it's funny, on GH2 and 3, you get the yellow stars even if you overstroke. But this is really hardcore. So yeah, all 6 stars. Trev's on the left, he's guitar, I'm on the right, I'm bass. I literally have not played this game since last time we played.
I played it for about an hour today, and that's about all I played extra. Literally Iggy Pop.
If you never listened to the Stooges, you really should. They only had 3 albums. Pick whichever one you want. It sounds like it was recorded in a trash can, but it's awesome. Mid-70s punk. Somehow Iggy Pop is still alive.
How?
And Keith
Richards. He looks like he was dead 20 years ago.
They're vampires. Maybe it's because he had a lust for life. Eh? Stars. I just remember what the next song is. Yes!
That's her favorite song of all time.
Nice story! Tell it to Reader's Digest! Can't be the end because I just got a star power.
It is a live version, so they could do anything they wanted. They could do all of War Pigs right now.
Please. Oh god, sorry.
I'm extremely mad. Drumming cards.
I got all those. Well, only 1.7 million, despite the fact that you constantly play 2 and 3 note chords.
And I didn't miss that much. I mean, then yeah. I missed, like, overstrummed most.
Yeah.
I missed one of the bear things, and then I overstrummed early on, but that's, like, pretty much it.
There was no solo in that one yet.
No.
Sounds about right. All right.
That's a song that would be impossible to do performance mode because strumming is all over the place. It's consistent.
Hello, me. Meet the real me.
So I'm just going to jump on vocals for this
How
song.
Did they come out with Rust in Megadeth come out with Rust in Peace in 1990, which is my favorite album of all time, of every album, and it's been that way for like 5 years, and then comes out with Countdown to Extinction in 1992, which is just lame. It has this song. It has Sympathy for Destruction. Symphony of Destruction, excuse me.
He knew that he could support his life off of Rust in Peace, so he just gave up.
And the album... The album before Rust in Peace was Peace Sells, which is silly, but awesome. Peace Sells has freaking Good Morning Black Friday on it, and Wake Up Dead. They're, like, amazing songs. Peace Sells is kind of, like, you know, silly, but Megadeth has always been silly. Even Rust in Peace is kind of silly. Like, Finger 18 is silly. But... Dave Mustaine, why? How can you make the most perfect album ever and then just not? How?
I have no idea where to use Star Power because you barely play notes
Hello
in the song.
Me, meet the real me, and my misfits way of life. The dark black past is mine.
There's no way he was being serious while making the song.
Hindsight is always 20/20. But looking back is still a bit fuzzy. Something to a short destruction. Nice story. Tell the Reader's Digest. Ready? I'm gonna hit it. Oh no, it's the third one, that's the best!
Me, a migraine headache! Sink down to your level! Just keep on thinking it's my fault! And stay an inch or two out of kicking distance!
Literally that Bart versus Lisa one where they're kicking each other. And you know the worst part is? This is their most popular album. Not Rust in Peace, Countdown to Extinction. Go away.
I think that happens to a lot of bands. Like, Metallica's most popular by far is Black.
Yeah.
Which isn't their worst, but it's definitely not their best.
Get ready for the solo to literally be chromatic scales. I'm not joking.
Yeah.
I'm not even that big of a music guy, and I know these are just chromatic scales. Get ready.
Okay.
this chord progression is awesome. Very simple, but I like it. Dave Mustaine is one of the most talented guitarists in the world, and he literally wrote a chromatic scale solo. Like, what the hell?
I think after Rust in Peace, he was just like, whatever. All Rust in Peace solos are insane.
I forget if the lead guitarist, I'm blanking on his name for Rust in Peace. I forget if he left after Rust in Peace. I think it was a while afterwards. This may surprise you with Dave Mustaine, but they had a huge falling out. Right?
What was the story for Dave Mustaine leaving Metallica? Was it like he kicked Lars Animal or something?
I think he kicked Lars Dog and he was just a big D-bag.
Yeah.
Sweating.
What is his problem?
Sweating. Well, me, it's nice talking to myself.
Credit to Dementia.
Someday you too will know my name. And smile with black tooth red.
With the war inside my head.
To the day I file. Fingers claw your back. Here I come.
You know, the worst part is he went from being a huge jerk to being the exact opposite, but super annoying. What is the worst thing you could be while still being a good person? I'm sorry. Let me take that back. What's the most annoying thing you could do while still being a very good person?
Oh, I used it.
Born again Christian. So he won't play any of his songs that has anything to do with the devil stuff. So like The Conjuring, all that stuff. Nothing.
Rip.
So he goes from being like the biggest jerk possible to being like, I'm born again. I can't play all these good songs because, you know, it is what it is. And it's like, Dave, there's a middle ground. Variety is the spice of life. There's something always in the middle.
No.
No, sir. All right. Nothing can be better than that. So go ahead and just turn off. No, just kidding.
I want to turn it off now.
Watch.
I want to play Scatterbrain.
Watch the entire thing. Oh, 9 minute song!
We have to do this and Spirit of Radio.
Is Spirit of Radio though?
Yeah.
At least, hey, the next game we play, is Warriors of Rock gonna be the next game we play? No, we're gonna play like Van Halen first.
Van Halen, but I was thinking about doing Rock Band 2 first.
Well, whatever. But in Warriors of Rock, which is the last Guitar Hero game, you have to play the entire 2112. Which sounds really cool, but it's actually pretty boring.
I actually don't like 2112. It's like, it's a 20-minute song, but 10 minutes of it is nothing.
Yeah, which is hence why it's like kind of boring.
Once you start being a prog band that is like, I don't know, you make your music more like an experience rather than just being like a technical marvel, it's like, that's when I don't care about prog anymore.
What about concept albums? Are they generally alright?
I'd have to listen to
them. Ah, well, I was just thinking like Between the Buried and Me's Colors or something like that.
Yeah, that's fine.
I like concept albums if they're not like too much.
I do like, I would say I pretty much like, I like albums that do have like clear distinctive songs that don't have like one theme that blends from one song to another, and it's hard to tell songs apart sometimes. I am though.
That's fair.
Like, Colors is a fine album. But I like a lot better.
So you'd prefer Three Cheers for Sweet Revenge to the Black Parade?
I like both of them a lot.
That's fair.
And again, like, Black Parade is like a concept album, but like, each song sounds so distinctive.
Yeah, that's definitely Yeah, my favorite Beatles album, which I think is the perfect Beatles album, is Revolver, which is not a concept album, unlike Sgt. Pepper's and Magical Mystery Tour and all that stuff.
Yeah.
I prefer it just, even though it's like, has a whole bunch of different like styles of songs, it's just friggin' amazing. I actually prefer Rubber Soul to like Sgt. Pepper. That's just
I generally like the middle albums of Beatles the most. My favorite is also probably Revolver.
Oh dang, we just got DMCA'd for just saying go catch on Beatles. This is Peter Frampton, right?
Yeah.
I know nothing about him except for the song. In fact, I'm gonna be honest, and I'm sorry for sounding like a flood here, YouTube land. When I hear Peter Frampton, I imagine Eric Clapton. I don't know why. I guess they're kind of like similar time period.
Yeah, kind of.
I don't even know what he looks like. Like, I'm just imagining Eric Clapton in my head. Dude! We need the boomers to buy this game. What can we put on? Like, this is fine. Like, it's a fine song.
And we're gonna have to do, like, a Children of Bodom song and probably, like, the next song after this. This game just has such tonal whiplash constantly.
I think the only one that has a worse tonal whiplash is freaking Van Halen, because all the guest acts are stupid as hell.
Yeah.
Isn't that the one that has Dope Nose by Weezer? We played Why Bother on this game, right?
Yes.
Okay, so it's literally... Yeah, Eddie Van Halen went... So, you know what song I really like is that Dope Nose by
the Weezer. So apparently the story behind the guest acts for Van Halen is that they literally looked at the iPod of Van Halen's son, and whatever was on there, like, let's just do that. Because they didn't give a crap.
My God.
But apparently that's the story. It was literally Van Halen's son's iPod, just whatever was on it.
Van Halen's son was the basis of the band then.
Yeah. So, I mean, it makes sense, but... Although you're gonna be doing that for the next 3 minutes.
Whatever.
This isn't fast enough.
You know what they don't have enough of? Fish songs. They have a llama, I wanna say, in Rock Band 3?
I think so.
They're really perfect for like everything. I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't have a bunch of Grateful Dead on Rock Band.
It.
A band I also never listened to anything of.
Yeah, that's me.
You're supposed to tap it, you're supposed to literally lay it out like a keyboard.
I main a pro keyboard on Rock Band 3 only.
I mean, that's a hell of a lot easier than pro guitar.
It is.
Like, you could be extremely good at guitar and still not do pro guitar, like, to an FC level.
I've said this before, but one time just from, like, YouTube recommended videos, it was, like, Freebird, first pro guitar FC.
I saw that one. I literally saw that
And, like, the video update was, like, a year ago. I mean, it might have been a couple years ago now, but it's, like, meh.
They wanted a challenge.
I got the pro FC 10 years after the game came out.
Well, literally anything on the standard GH engine, someone like Akai or something is just gonna, like, kill it.
Yeah.
Instantly. I mean, a couple people have done Soulless 5, which is, like, a 35-minute song? Like, get real.
Dude, people like Akai, the thing that is so amazing about players of that caliber isn't that they can hit a bunch of, like, stupid tap notes. It's that they have the muscle memory to control their beat per minute for strums to be so precise that he could hit, like, green grass on Rock Band 1.
Yeah.
It's like, you have to have absolute perfect muscle memory and rhythm to do that.
That's why
That is the most impressive thing to me about, like, players at that level.
I specifically, like Akai because he will, like, like, go through the actual games on the actual engines. Because, like, if you went on Clone Hero and FC Green Grass, I'd be like, cool. Because, like, Clone Hero is so... Oh, yeah. Clone Hero is so easy. Like, I'm sorry.
Yeah. The timing window is so much higher than even, like, GH3, which is, like, universally the easiest to hit notes.
Yeah. So, like, when he goes on, like, Guitar Hero Van Halen and plays that... I forget what that one crazy song was. It's something you wouldn't even think of. It wasn't even, like, Hot Teacher.
Oh, yeah, it's... I know the exact song you're talking
all
about.
All it takes is one measure of extremely fast drumming, yeah. And you're like, oh, can't FC it. Gotta get a GH2 PAL 360 system.
Yeah, and it gets to console limitations. Like, the game runs at 60 FPS, and, like, I think it was something like 22 notes per second. So you have, like, two or three frames to hit each one, and you have to change the fret every other note. It's so insane. If I'd, like, literally grind that for a year straight, I would quit my job, do it 12 hours a day. I don't think I could do it in a year.
It is pretty insane. I like how you're doing the talk box. I mean, I guess. What else would you be doing, you know? Is this where Kanye got it? Run away from me, babe. Oh, is that song on Rock Band? I guess it wouldn't be.
I have no idea.
Like every white person in my 30s, my favorite rap album is My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy by Kanye. Literally everyone who's like in their mid-30s.
It's like the only rap album that isn't rap. I mean, it's rap, but...
I mean, I really like Kendrick Lamar, too, because his stuff is actually like concept-y and... It actually feels like something. No! Oh, sorry. To Pimp a Butterfly, and I think it's just self-titled. It's really good by Kendrick, but yeah. Kanye is, I hate to say it, folks, but Kanye is a musical genius. Like, he may be real dumb at a lot of things, which is why I don't know if he is officially autistic, but he's autistic. Because he's such a genius at one thing and so freaking stupid at others.
Yeah, he's very socially aware.
And I don't say that in the negative, of course. More than likely, I am on the spectrum in some way. I'm sitting here on a Friday night, why are you here? Playing GH5 for the YouTube channel. So let's be real, folks. But yeah, Kanye is a musical genius. That is the long and the short. Also, Kurt Cobain didn't kill himself. When's the last time I threw that in? A couple months ago?
It's probably the little... I bet if you looked at the last part of GH5 we did, you said it.
Well, in real life, I haven't said it. Look at the tapes, man.
If I was in the crowd for this song, I'd be like, get on with it.
Literally everyone there is, like, extremely high. When was this done? In, like, the late 70s? Yeah.
I guess it would be fun anyway.
I missed twice during this out of sheer boredom.
I got it. And, like, this is...
Like, it's cool.
And it's, like... slow enough that the notes are, like, spaced out enough that, like, hammer-ons aren't a given and you have to pay attention. I hate songs like this.
So you're doing the meme strumming every single note. Bass.
Piece of crap. I didn't have an FC, but...
How... I mean, I understand this song is very loud, but... Or very fast. Very long. Oh my gosh, sorry. But we have 2.1 million. When we only got 1.7 million in Lust for Life.
Is it, like, delayed?
I'm just gonna pause. Yeah, it literally is. Okay. Yeah, that seems better.
Okay, so it still happens in this game, that's great.
Just not nearly as long.
Yeah, you need, like, a little 10-minute song.
If you watched our Guitar Hero Metallica playthrough, which, hey, if you didn't, we have it up on the channel. Guitar Hero Metallica on pretty much any system had this thing where if the songs were longer than like 5 minutes long, no matter what, they would get off a beat.
It literally ruins the game.
At some point on any Metallica song over like 5 minutes long, you would have to pause.
Literally 80% of them.
Yep.
It, like, I've said this, if you watch that, it's like one of those things that, like, you can tell, like, I just am, like, more and more bothered by it as we go on. It literally ruins the game.
No, it does. I mean, something like All Nightmare Long, you know, like, imagine if you have an FC, and it gets, like, to be, like half a beat off.
Yeah, and you
like,
have...
it's pretty bad.
And the only way to fix it is to pause the game while, while holding a sustain note and letting go of the sustain note, which is not the easiest thing in the world when you're playing hard as butt Metallica.
Well, imagine you're playing Fight Fire with Fire.
Yeah.
Like,
and you have to do it like for, I don't know. Like,
when do you have time to do that?
Yeah.
Like on Fight Fire with Fire.
And like the really long times, sometimes you have to like fix it multiple times.
Yep. Like one or something like that.
No.
Oh my god.
Are you kidding me?
Holy crap.
Whatever the diamond challenge was, I just got it.
Oh my god!
Literally 5 seconds.
Can you see what it was? Did you finish like we did? Get it? So you finished the damn song. We got 5 gamer fuel.
That's a not that hard of an FC, but it's mostly just playing a 10-minute song.
Oh, but the end is the hardest part!
I nailed it, though. Just saying.
Oh, seriously? Rip. Alright, what was the diamond challenge? It doesn't even say. Ah, oh, sweet.
It has to be, like, holding a 4x the multiplier.
Just click on it, yeah. I guess.
Oh, hammer-ons and pull-offs.
1160!
Yeah, I got 1160.
Alright.